Today's Formula One barge boards are incredibly complex pieces of engineering. To some, they might even be considered art. The plethora of boomerangs, fins, slots, and teeth all serve one purpose: to drive airflow outwards and protect the floor from any prevailing turbulence. But in 2022, these will be gone, and barge boards will, in Formula One, be relegated to the history books. But do you know when the first barge boards emerged in Formula One? They've come a long way since their early iterations, so without further ado, this is the evolution of the bargeboard. In reality, there's two answers to the question, when did the first bargeboard appear in F1? The first use of an aerodynamic piece to channel the turbulence from the front tyres away from the car was on the Lotus 97T of 1985, mounted to the front suspension. This guided airflow outwards, allowing it to push the pocket of wake behind the tyres outwards so it didn't interrupt the cleaner airflow moving underneath the car. But it would be fair to say that these early bargeboards didn't catch on. Although they were used sporadically, the turn of the 1990s coincided with most teams extending the front wing end plates further back to generate a similar effect. By 1993, however, the bargeboard as we know it today first appeared on the McLaren MP48. Former McLaren aerodynamicist Henri Durand says that the introduction of the bargeboard was one of his favourite technical achievements in introducing the design, which first appeared at the season opener in Kyle Army. The design was essentially just a big panel connected to the chassis bulkhead that would help wash turbulence away from the floor and the sidepod inlets. But even in an age when Formula One was less technologically advanced, it was still Formula One, and two races later at the deluge hit Donington, Benetton brought its own version. Funnily enough, McLaren was involved in debate with the FIA over the Benetton bargeboard's legality. Durand argued that Benetton's version didn't match the side profile of the car as required thanks to its high nose. However, Charlie Whiting let it pass, causing Durand, in his own words, to become cheesed off. Bargeboards took a little while to catch on, however, and few teams experimented in 1993 too, like Footwork and Minardi, but the sudden technical changes levied on F1 in 1994, after Ayrton Senna's death, brought them into the mainstream. By the 1994 Spanish Grand Prix, the extended front wing end plates had been banned, and so the teams turned to the bargeboards to perform the same job, most introducing their own versions at Barcelona. Most were, like the Benetton and McLaren designs, relatively rudimentary panels, although Ferrari developed quite a complex design, for the time at least, for Spain. Bargeboards had come a long way by 1995, and were often lower and more curvaceous to reduce the impact on the sidepod inlets and transit of flow to the radiators. Instead, they were designed to focus on protecting the lower portion of the floor, rather than around the entire face of the sidepods. They continued to work in that vein throughout the rest of the 1990s, with Jordan being the only real anomaly during that time, as it instead focused on resurrecting the suspension-mounted bargeboards to do the work sooner. Benetton had a particularly odd design in 1998 and 1999, introducing small bargeboards attached to a big aerofoil, which appeared to direct airflow downwards and around the sidepods, but perhaps at the expense of generating lift. Going into the new millennium, teams began to experiment with the contours of the sidepods, bringing the lower half further inwards to work more closely with the airflow being fired underneath the nose. Ferrari then began to add to the bottom section in 2002, adding a jagged plate to the bottom to introduce vortices and energise the airflow. Aero development with bargeboards had started to reach fever pitch. The Scuderia went into 2003 with an extra bargeboard element ahead of the main panel, also adding a fin to give the oncoming airflow some extra direction. Around this time, teams started to experiment with sidepod undercuts and sculpting, giving bargeboards more to do with helping direct airflow around that undercut. Then came the additions that attached to the front of the sidepod, inspired by Jordan's 2004 chassis fin, as aero development began to increase in complexity. Toyota was next to adopt them in 2005, before they became far more commonplace in 2006 and 2007, as the main bargeboard designs continued to sprout all sorts of fins and additions. Then for 2009, the size of the bargeboards was drastically scaled down. This left the teams with a tiny bargeboard to play with mounted to the floor, and a vertical turning vane next to the sidepod opening, often doubling up as a mirror mounting. Of course, the teams used those devices as much as they could to break down the wake of the front wheels, and over the next 7 years, teams would split up the turning vanes or the small bargeboards to create vortices or provide greater flow management in this area. But then in 2017, as Formula One went on an arguably misguided journey to improve the speeds of the cars, the bargeboard areas were opened up again, paving the way for what can only be described as ridiculousness. Even if the main bargeboard area looked relatively simple at the Melbourne season opener, the likes of Mercedes and Ferrari had exploited the full area for the sidepod mounted elements. Still, it seemed innocuous enough at the time, but then the development race began. If you compare the bargeboard packages between the start and the end of 2017, you'll notice the massive increase in slots, cuts, fins and the like, but even then they still look incredibly simple compared to today. As of 2021, the bargeboards become toothier, strakier and boomerangier than ever. With the 2019 changes to reduce the effect of the front wing, they became even more important, but such is their ridiculousness is that they'll all be gone by 2022, as long as everything goes according to plan. They're a long way away from those halcyon days of 1993 where a slightly curved panel would do the trick, but arguably, they work in just the same way.